All right, today we're going to be talking about insurance cards, the exemptions, the card to be kept inside of the vehicle, our displayed electronic image, insurance company, and what they're supposed to provide to you. The state statute code is 6315.4. 1. The following are exempted from the requirements of this section. Motor vehicles exempt by section 6315.5, which when I get done reading this law, I'll tell you what that one is, but the short definition is government vehicle. B. Motor vehicles with a bond or certificate of deposit of money or securities in at least the minimum amount requirement for the proof of financial responsibility that would be filed with the department. When they say department in this law, they're talking about Department of Public Safety. Motor vehicles that are self-insured under section 6315.53, implements of husbandry. 2A. Every motor vehicle operated in this state shall have a motor vehicle liability insurance policy that covers the vehicle and is in compliance with the liabilities limits required by section 6315.3J. The insured party shall be responsible for maintaining the insurance on each vehicle. 2B. An insurance company issuing a policy of motor vehicle liability insurance as required by this section shall furnish to the insured. An insurance company issuing a policy of motor vehicle liability insurance as required by this section shall furnish the insurance an insurance card for each motor vehicle at the time of insurance policy. At the time the insurance policy becomes effective, the insurance card may be furnished in either paper or electronic format as chosen by the insured. Acceptable electronic formats include display of electronic image on a cell phone or any other type of electronic device beginning on July 1st, 2013. Insurance shall furnish commercial auto coverage customers with an insurance card clearly marked with identifier commercial auto insurance or fleet or similar language to reflect the vehicle is insured under a commercial auto policy. 3. Upon stopping a motor vehicle at a roadblock where all passing motorists are checked as a method to enforce traffic laws or upon stopping a motor vehicle for any other statutory violation, a law enforcement officer who is authorized to issue traffic citations shall verify that the insurance card required by this section is in the motor vehicle or is displayed by electronic image on a cell phone or other type of electronic device. However, no driver shall be stopped or detained solely for the purpose of verifying that the motor vehicle is covered by liability insurance in the amount required under section 6315.3J. Unless the stop is part of such roadblock. If the law enforcement officer uses the verification system in section 6316.3 and receives a response from the system verifying that the owner of the motor vehicle has liability insurance in the amounts required under section 6315.3J, then the officer shall not issue a citation under this section, notwithstanding any failure to display an insurance card by the owner or operator. There's a common misconception that people believe when officers are on a safety checkpoint, we cannot check their insurance card, which is not the case. That law right there, that part of the law, clearly states that any officer that has the ability to write tickets and is commissioned by the state can write you a citation and check for insurance at a safety checkpoint. Insurance is a secondary violation, which means if you're driving down the road, we can't pull you over just to check to see if you have insurance. But if we pull you over for any other violation, then we check for insurance. Secondly, that's what they're saying about the sole purpose of just check. 4. Failure of the owner or the operator of a motor vehicle to have the insurance card in the motor vehicle or display the insurance card by electronic image on a cellular phone other type electronic device is a misdemeanor upon conviction is punishable by a fine of $100 and suspension of driver license periods for a period of 1 year until the owner of the motor vehicle shows proof of liability insurance that is compliance with the liability limits required by section 6315.3J and has paid the fines and assessments imposed on the driver's license reinstatement fees imposed by the Department of Public Safety. A judge shall determine whether the defendant is indigent, and if a determination of indigence is made, shall authorize the reinstatement of the person's driver's license upon proof of mandatory liability insurance subject to compliance with a payment plan for any fines, assessment, and/or fees. Fraudulent use of an insurance card shall be punishable in accordance with section 97710. If such fines are levied in a municipal court, the funds from such fines shall be deposited in the general fund of the municipality. as such fines are levied in any of the courts of the county. The funds from such fines shall be deposited in the general fund of the county. A person convicted of a criminal offense under the subsection 4 shall not be convicted of a criminal offense under section 63.16.13.1 arising from the same incident. 5. If at the hearing date or the date of payment of the fine, the owner shows proof of such insurance was in effect in the time of citation, the case shall be dismissed as the defendant with prejudice and all court costs shall be waived against the defendant. 6. No law enforcement officer may access any function, feature, or other electronic image on a person's cellular phone or other type of electronic device when enforcing the provision of this section, except for the electronic image of insurance cards shown to the officer. Go back to 4. That's just saying if you don't have insurance, you go to court, what have you, and you don't show proof of insurance, your license will be suspended. There's no way around it. 5 is saying that if you come to court and you can show proof of insurance at the time that the ticket was wrote, there's a date and time on every citation. If you can show that you had insurance at that time, because all insurance cards are dated, that ticket will be dismissed with no court. 6 is just stating that when you hand a officer your phone and it has the picture of the license pulled up, they can't look at anything else in your phone. That's the only thing they're allowed to look at. 63.15.5, that is just the government-owned vehicles are exempt from having to have insurance cards inside the vehicles. 63.15.53 is self-insurance. I'm going to do a different video on that one. So come back, you'll see a different video on that. I'm going to do different videos on all of them. I'm going to go ahead and make separate videos. And 63.15.3 is just the definitions. Breaks down what each thing means under this section of law. I'll do a separate video on those too if you want to see them. They'll be in there. 63.16.3 is just the creation of electronic motor vehicle insurance verification system. System requirements. Now, this hasn't always been the case. Recently, they've actually got the system up and running. It requires that insurance companies, once you pay them, they are to tag the insurance on your VIN number. In return, when they do that, sometimes check through your tag, because your tag is linked to your VIN number also, that whether you have insurance or not. So you need to check with your insurance company to make sure that they are doing that. They will also have the ability to cancel your insurance policy on your tag from a missed payment. That's another reason why they done it. It's a lot quicker way to check. It's a lot easier system, because some people will get insurance cards and they will not pay the monthly payment. So they have an insurance card that's good, but they actually don't have car insurance. 97.710 is just fraudulent paperwork. That was when if you hand somebody a car that you know is not good and you claim that it is, you can be charged a separate crime. The 97 code is going to be your criminal crime code, so it's going to be different than your 63 codes, which is traffic codes. 63.16.13 is failure to maintain liability insurance and uninsured motorist identification fund. Like I said, I'm going to do separate videos on all these, so make sure you check back with that. If you got something out of this video, please hit the like button. Let's keep the channel going. Share it, subscribe, hit the bell notification. And if there's anything that you want to know or a part that you didn't understand, please comment it below and I will respond back to you there and do a video. I'm going to do a Q&A video when I get enough questions. So please comment, like, share. Let's keep it going. Have a great day.